invite your attention to the fundamental problems before the country like unemployment and poverty. It is time that you should rather think of these instead of indulging in petty problems such as the communal question, which affects a handful of people and has nothing to do with the masses. Political freedom and brave tackling of the economic issues can settle these problems, and inevitably political freedom takes the first place. But political freedom itself must be considered in terms of these problems and not as if it stands by itself in the air. Hence, it becomes necessary to consider the economic problems of the country, the agrarian problems, the industrial problems, and others which have produced this terrible poverty. As a result of foreign domination, we had to suffer a lot. Socialism has been much discussed in the country, and some people have objected to it. I believe that the socialist way provides a remedy for these difficulties. But what I'm most concerned with is a thorough discussion of these problems from every possible view, both nationally and internationally. We cannot ignore the international aspect, as it is well known that international factors produce great depression and fall in prices and other difficulties. Let those who do not believe in socialism produce well throughout schemes of solving these problems, and we shall consider them and decide democratically what is the best for us all. This discussion is good and helps in educating the masses and making them feel that their troubles are essential parts of the national movement. It helps also in clarifying our own minds and gives us a better perspective of what is happening and what we are aiming at. I'm glad that this organization has undertaken to draw up an agrarian program after full discussion with the people really affected by the present problems. But we must always remember that the primary and essential job before us is to obtain political freedom, and we must all join hands and forces to gain this. It is certain that the organization will take part in the elections. It will do so, I'm sure, with success. It will not go to voters as a beggar for votes, for individuals on their supposed merits, but as the standard bearer of India's flag of freedom, asking all those who believe in independence to stand in its bank and support it. There are are many other groups rising all over the country, hoping to get into the new councils and perhaps to share the benefits of power and other advantages. Let us ask each and every one of them where they stand in regard to independence and complete freedom. There need not be any more doubt that it is this organization and this organization alone which has actually and bravely fought for India's freedom and will continue to do so. Let us therefore not waste our energy and time in connection with minor issues. The big issue demands our attention. India's self-respect demands that counts here as well as in other countries when India is considered. It must be remembered that we are going to the new councils to fight each other and not to get petty benefits out of them.